Well, Canada's art market is soaring during the pandemic as consumers are turning to online auctions more than ever. Rob Cowley, president of Cowley Abbott, sharing some key factors to consider when looking to start to build your art collection. Good morning. Thanks for joining us.
Of course, Bob. How are you doing today?
Good, good. I want to start actually with selling, because many of us would perhaps inherit pieces of art or find something interesting at a yard sale or maybe at a donation center near North Bay that was painted by David Bowie and buy it for $5 and just sell it for $88,000. That was in the news. So how do we go about getting appraisals and selling the pieces we already have?
Well, it's true. We're finding more and more that people are curious about works they inherit or works that they... Sometimes they may be just making a decision to have a garage sale and want to make sure what they've purchased doesn't have great value. And so you can contact us. It's always best to contact an expert. And certainly if you send you the details to mail@cowleyabbott.ca, we offer free virtual appraisals. We're doing that throughout the summer, and we're always happy to assist.
Okay. Art investment, as if the stock market isn't giving us enough grief. Why is art a good investment?
Well, we're finding more and more, certainly what we found through the pandemic is that many works of art that were even purchased 15 and 20 years ago, there's many areas where there's been an increase in value. That's often based on buying with some education behind it, of course, making careful purchases, also buying what you like. But more and more, we're finding that clients are branching out, not just investing in stocks and other areas, but also looking at art as an investment.
So it's good to have it as a piece of the pie in your portfolio. So let's get to what we need to look for newbies. Give us the 101 here. Apparently there's a 10 commandments.
There is. So there's definitely factors to look at when you're looking to start your collection or continue your collection. The most obvious first commandment of the 10 is the artist. So a work of art by, you know, a member of the Group of Seven, like this work here by Franklin Carmichael, is going to carry more value than a lesser known artist. Like this painting here will be offered in our fall auction between $60,000 and $80,000. His work, most recently we sold a work the same size for over $140,000, again an indicator of the market. Subject matter is very important as well. An artist like P.C. Shepherd, who was actually a friend of the Group of Seven, but also a fantastic painter as well. Here's two works by him. Here's a self-portrait at $3,000 to $5,000, and here's a fantastic landscape as well at $10,000 to $15,000. And so what he's best known for is landscape, but then you can also find that certainly a self-portrait is going to be very special as well. So both of these works are of high quality, another factor that we look at, and so they would probably hold value as well over time.
Okay. Can artists fall out of fashion, like fashion, so they're not their value may drop?
It can happen. So fashion is actually one of the factors that we look at. And so, you know, you can have artists that may have traded at a very high level, let's say in the 2000s or the 1990s, that don't trade at the same level now. We find that with a lot of 19th century painters, a lot of watercolor painters that aren't as popular as they once were. But if the right work comes along, then collectors may respond. On the other side of fashion can be, you know, the great popularity of an artist like Maude Lewis, of course.
So there was
a movie. Movie released Maudie in 2016 that's really set her market on fire. Sold a work for over $40,000. These works were trading between $2,500 and $5,000 about 15, 20 years ago. This work's between $8,000 and $10,000. It's not the most popular subject, but one of her best known subjects. So between $8,000 and $10,000, and that's in our online auction that opens tomorrow.
Yeah, my daughter was just obsessed with her folk art. We actually went to the museum in Nova Scotia and really soaked up her work. So she's a good investment. What else? Are there certain types or categories that are really hot in the market?
You're finding that both historical and post-war, so even abstraction, are very popular right now. A great example here and a great investment, this is a work by Rita Laton, the Quebec painter, the abstract painter. We recently sold one of her original paintings for about $30,000. This is a print, so it was created by the artist, but there's multiples.
Okay, how much for the print?
$1,000 to $1,500.
Okay, do you do layaway, Rob?
We can try.
We'll hook up your website at chh.com. Rob Cowley, Cowley Abbott, thanks.
Thanks.